not sure who it's LVP. I'm not sure who what the initials that is. All right, boys, we got this game. Let's get it.
It's a clean sheet of ice and a beautiful night for hockey. Hi, everybody. James Cebulski along with Ray Ferraro for EA Sports. It is about time to drop the puck. Both teams seem ready, and they are about to drop the puck on this opening faceoff. The Phantoms start with possession as we are now underway. Puck exits the zone. Nice feed. Shot! Scores! And look who it is! His first goal with his new EASHL team!
The excitement that he displays when that puck goes into the net, you know how much this means. You will never forget your first goal.
Big play inside the defensive zone. Tees him up! Denies him on the play!
Everybody in the building knows they're trying to find him for the one-timer, and when it comes, can he shoot it? But the goalie's right on it. Followed, tracked the puck, and made the save.
Hangs onto the puck. Boom! What a hit!
Man, she knocked him right over, right through the chest. A solid hit.
My goodness, they are really starting to dial up the pressure here now! Connect the pass and they'll be forced to regroup. Break away. Scores! Wow, what a goal!
Nice hands, great finish. Little short break and it's in the net.
Guys, this is his first goal with this club here. And you know, you never forget your first goal. I'm sure his teammates aren't going to forget it either.
The Wolves win the faceoff. Puck sent over to King. And then it's blocked from someone in front.
It's a big hit right over there.
The Phantoms pick up all alone! And he can't get the shot off!
I hope he's not waiting for a
prize. He scores! That's three, Ray!
Yeah, just haven't taken their foot off the gas pedal at all here. Once they got that first one, they kept pushing away. Now they've got three.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. Lehigh Valley's really put the squeeze on here now, up by three. 2-on-1! Went for the dirty dangle and it goes sideways.
Come on, boys.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck to get play back underway.
Tie up. Let's go.
Off the draw and a nice job locking up his opponent. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
He bails his guys out again. I mean, he probably could use a little help. The guy's standing right in the middle of the ice.
There
he shoots this
pick,
he drops it, and makes a really good save.
Denied by the goaltender. Jones has the puck.
I try to shoot that side of the net every day.
I think that's a pretty heady play. There's been a little bit of scramble around him, and he jumps on it. They can get reorganized. King's leadership is often by example, not so much with some great speech in the locker room. They need action now. They've got to get back in this game, and the captain's going to have to lead them to it.
Takes a shot. Love save, and just enough of it. Toronto's got a hold of it against the wall. Shot, and that goes out of a player in front. Stopped by the goaltender.
Read of the play was perfect, but it's his quickness that gets out tight to the puck, so the shooter can't elevate it anywhere. There's nowhere for the puck to go.
Lehigh Valley's got the puck against the boards. Toronto's got control of it now from their own end. Skates to the crease, and he easily stops that one. Dishes it to Abdullah. They get a pair on a 2-on-1. Takes a shot. Stopped with ease. Now a quick pass to King. Picking up steam in the offensive zone. Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. Save and a beaut by Jones.
He tries his puck really to get himself into position for this save. This is not an easy one. Right from the middle of the ice.
And a solid save on the play there.
Yeah, he got out tight to him, James. There's nowhere for that puck to go.
Block.
And he hangs on just as time runs out. That'll do it for period number one. We'll drop the puck on the second period in just moments. All right, I think my partner in crime, Ray Ferraro, is rested and refreshed, along with the teams. We're ready to get things underway. A one-sided affair after the first 20 minutes. Here we go for period number two. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
Toronto's first period was a mess. I mean, they were late to almost every puck. They started sluggishly, like they didn't have their legs. Sometimes that happens. Now they got to find a way to get back in the game, James, and it's got to start now.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. It has been a one-sided affair. 3-0 is where we sit. Good read by the winger as the two centers tie up. Driving right to the front! Maintains possession. Moves it to Abdullah. On the attack along the boards. Manages to hang on. Here's a short pass to King. Sends it to the middle! And that carries off a swing in front of the net. And that goes off course off a body. Great stop by Jones.
I think he's the only guy in the building more surprised than me that that didn't go in. He always scores in tight.
Oh, they probably want to redo on that. Excellent stick work on the play. Toronto's got the puck along the boards. Look out, a two-on-one. The Wolves play it along the wing. And he comes up with it.
Jones makes the save, and I think the biggest problem a goalie has with a big lead is, how do I stay in the game? He hasn't had much to do. You've got to stay sharp yourself. That's close, James. The goaltender ends up beating the shooter to the post. As that looks like it's a goal, but it's shut down.
Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. And the ice has been tilted to this point. 3-0 is where we sit right now. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Across the line from center. Stoppage in play as we get an offside. Crowd's buzzing, ready to get things back underway, and I think the officials are too. The Phantoms win the draw here in the neutral zone. Couldn't make the connection on the play. Takes it to the net! He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. The Wolves take possession in the defensive end. Split feed.
For the boys, buddy.
There's a collision with some authority. King's going to play it against the half wall. Lehigh Valley's got the puck along the boards. And now he moves it to Abdullah. His reflexes on display tonight. Unable to reach that one. Picked up along the boards by Abdullah. Toronto's got possession here in the offensive zone. Fantastic save! Slides it up ahead from the right wing. Takes the stretch pass here in the open ice. Into the corner of the attacking area. Toronto's got it behind the net. Lehigh Valley's got the puck along the wall. Couldn't catch up to that pass. Lehigh Valley. Larceny on that stop right there.
Oh.
Here in the late going to the frame. 3-0 is where we sit. Toronto's got it in the defensive zone. Lehigh Valley's got it along the wall. Gained possession along the boards. On the attack into the offensive end, right up the gut. And they score! We've seen this sack before, Razor.
You get in that close, and he's got the puck. Good night. He doesn't miss from there.
Toronto's answered back here in the late stages of the second.
They have to hope this goal signifies the point in the game where it turns. They haven't been very good up until this point.
Can't make it work. And we're going to get a face-off after the offside. Play ready to resume as everybody lines in for the face-off. They take possession as he locks them up off the face-off. All right, that brings period period number two to an end. The ice resurfacer's coming out onto the ice. They'll give it a little cleaning, and I can see Ray Ferraro down there between the benches tap dancing. I can only imagine where he needs to go. Third period, just around the corner.
It was a little better of a period, but...
Ready. Ray's ready. The players are ready. Let's go. And the puck is dropped, and we are underway here in the third. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
The Wolves are in the position they deserve right now, James. They're behind in the game. They haven't had the puck much. They're running around trying to get it back.
Quick feed to Abdullah. Intercepts it at center.
Toronto's played a really good game here. I like the way that they've checked. They turned pucks over. Now they want to make something out of all this puck possession.
Oh, they needed that, and he misses.
In close, he's one of the game's most dangerous shooters. This one just doesn't hit the net.
Scores! That's two times, two times!
Now he's having one of those nights, James. The puck's just following him around. You get a chance to score, you don't miss on nights like this.
Kings won the draw here in the neutral zone. With possession along the wall.
Can you just put on the plate?
360 with the puck.
Why was... What's with the backhands?
The Phantoms have it now.
Oh, of course they do.
Icing is the call. We'll get a reset.
Hope you had a great playoff run.
Still lots of time left in the period. Lehigh Valley's got a three-goal lead. Fillier's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone.
Hey, maybe you can create some offense against the tired team after the icing.
Pass out front! And he denies that! Great opportunity there!
Well, I tried
the pass! Goes right to the crease! Toronto's got a hold out along the wall. Here's a shot!
God.
Two in a row. One, you stay hungry, you want to stay on your toes, and while the defending team's back on their heels, they throw another one on the board.
Lehigh Valley's added to their lead here in this third period. It's been nonstop.
I like how they've scored and then gone after the next one, James. They've had their foot down on the gas pedal the whole night.
They've got the defense outnumbered. It's a contact sport, people. There's proof right there. And that's stopped. And the puck departs the zone. The Wolves will play it in their own end. Here they come on the attack. He scores!
What a hit.
Captain leading by example. Toronto's back at center ice. They have a long way to go still here, though, Ray.
Yeah, get your scorers out there, James. Don't worry about the defensive end of the ice. You need goals.
And now he angles it across to Fillier. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Across the line. Toronto's got control of it now here in the offensive end.
Oh, no way.
And he regains control of the puck. Stopped by the goaltender, getting a piece of that one. Lehigh Valley's got it in their own zone. Picks it off. They go back on the attack. Good save by the goalie. Battle along the boards for the puck. Take it along the wall, but try to turn on the chance here. And he comes up with a big stop on the breakaway.
Almost like the shooter waited and waited, and the opening never came.
And they'll go the other way with a great play by Fillier. And the goaltender comes up with a of it to keep it out of the net. Handles the pass at center. Less than 60 seconds to play.
Crosby's not coming now.
King's got control of the puck in the corner. That's just textbook positioning to break up the play. Lehigh Valley's got a hold of it against the wall. Can't find his man. And we'll reset things after that icing. In the final moments of this period, the Wolves have a long way to go to try to get back into this one, down by three. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. That opportunity is rejected. Centering feed! What a chance, but they can't connect! Made the stop on the play.
Good save. Positional save through trap.
Sends it over! Drives to the
oh,
point!
Man.
Handles the puck. Oh, what a chance here! Can they make it happen on this 2-on-1? Denies that opportunity.
I like the way he tracks the puck here. He's got to find it, and then he gets his body way in front of it. That's a good save.
And this one comes to an end. Well, at least definitely for him, a where-were-you moment in EASHL history. He gets his first win with the new team. That's got to be huge mentally, Razor.
It is for sure, James. I mean, they bring you in to try and be part of the solution. They bring you in because they have a need and goal for somebody to make some stops. He was terrific.
It was our wing, man. I'm sorry, but he didn't pass when he should have passed. I don't know. I just couldn't play with him very well. I'm hoping Fatty and enough for you to bust this out a couple balls. Yeah. Sub Fap. Daddy! We're waiting for the swing guy to leave and then we can invite you in. But he ain't leaving. Are we home or away? We're away, right? And the code. No, we're playing the Marlies, are we? Oh, that's, oh, Max Payne and Giant KV. They're all right. He was my GM last season, Max Payne. You can't take that. Yeah. sent you the invite, Fatty. Put mine on the floor there. We didn't need pitchers, we lost. Bye. Rather center.
Yeah. playing bad defense. I need you to stop that. Revitalize the position of the team for whatever reason you need to be able to look at the game. And you know, so the Panthers get an early power play, and I'm thinking, okay, this might be good because essentially early power plays don't do very much. How long was I? They in fact had six shots on goal, started at that Bennett chance, then Barkov, they literally had so many slot chances here in the first period. Wall was amazing. Then unfortunately, here's where the battle starts when you talk about don't think too much. With 5 seconds left on the power play, you're going to see pass and net left blocks it through, even though Wall gets a little piece of it. That is discouraging. And then you see Clara spot for him. And you wonder, Ron, behind the scenes, are they trying to move him side to side? And I think there's something to that. It could be coincidence, but it could be something that, hey, listen, kid, you know, inexperienced, let's get him to move. Maybe think a little bit more than he should.
Meanwhile, the other end of the ice, Bobrovsky's shot out.
It's like 5 seconds. Dude, our wing. Oh, I was yelling the whole game. Our wing was horrible. He never passed to me once when I was wide open.
He talked it.
Oh yeah, big time.
What?
Hurley or Herxley or. Well, I know that me, Maddie, Soupy, and some other guy played this afternoon. He dominated the ice. It was great. All right, the first game. But me too. Oh, was it double? Double dose? Oh, right. Oh, tank. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That dude, I'm sorry he was there. He's like one of the worst players I know. Like, you could have like 50,000 RP, play one night with him, and you'd be down to 5 RP. Yeah, when he went back to D, yeah. Yeah, that's where he usually plays, but, you know, he's an old guy and he cries, so we let him play up front sometimes. I think they said they were... Oh, he better not. Oh, I lent him my team. He better not make me shame it.
Thank you.
Can I have your lighter? You didn't bring mine out. Now he wants to reschedule. I know from talking with Hurricanes right now, see what he wants to do. He's the boss. Yeah, yeah. It's Toronto. I'm talking with Max Payne right now, who's the owner of Toronto and Hurricanes.
Oh.
Yeah, alright. Yeah, let's play an RP. Yeah. We're losing 2-0 starting the second.
Welcome back to EA Sports. Beautiful night for hockey. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's get it going tonight. Tonight. The Wolves take possession here on the opening draw, and we are underway. Oh, they couldn't connect on the play. There's the whistle. We're going to get ourselves
that's a penalty?
A shot here.
Four. 2-0 before the start of the second.
Off the wing, he comes up with it. With both centers scrummed up.
Sorry, it's only the second.
Puck in the defensive zone. Quick feed to King.
Nice.
What a way to finish that. Got a jump in their step tonight as they strike early.
Well, that's going to help as well, James. Now you've got the lead. The guys feel good about themselves, and they can attack with the cushion of a one-goal lead.
Getting a little physical there with that collision. New York. got the puck along the boards. Moves it quickly over to Fisher. Oh, great save there!
We watched him do this before. I mean, he gets himself into a position where he's protecting the puck, keeping the defender at arm's length away, and then waiting till the chance arises that he can get it on the net.
Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. Toronto's up 1-0. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Fisher's got it in the defensive end. Oh, he had the right idea but couldn't make that play with the pass. The seventh round prospects have a hold of it in the defensive zone. New York's gained the line and into the zone. And there's the save. Pushes it across to King. Here we go, it's a 2-on-1. And that's broken up.
They got the first one, and I was really interested to see how they would respond. They kept the pressure on.
And the centers glide towards the dot here as we got a face-off set to go. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Ooh, and she serves up a cold glass of truculence with that.
Oh, she doesn't miss on this.
In all alone on the breakaway.
The defender got beat once and then saved himself and his partner later on with a good play.
Oh boy, here's trouble. 2-on-1. Pass broken up. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Redirected in front. Makes it look easy with the stop. Sends a pass over.
Now we rescheduled with him.
Fisher's moving the puck through his own zone and tries to make a diagonal pass
first,
to
First night, you know, I can't be a dick.
Fires it. Oh, what a stop. Toronto's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Grabs control of it at the point. And that pass doesn't go. New York's got the puck along the wall. Can't make the connection on the pass. Looks to make a play over to King. Makes a move in front. Gets in front of it for the block. B-Buddy's lugging the puck. Picking up momentum across the zone here on the right side. Toronto's looking to break out of their own end. Quick stop. Scores! And in the dying seconds, they get one here. Uplifting at one end, deflating at the other, Razor.
Wow, that's a kick in the shins to give up this goal late. But what a shot of adrenaline going into the intermission when you get one this late in a period.
Face off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Takes a shot. He scores. He buzzer beater before the end of the frame.
Well, this will be a great piece of video for the coaches to show in the intermission how they got after the puck, they stayed with it, and score so late in this period. I don't think the goaltender gets a look at this at all, James. He just drops into the butterfly. He's hoping the thing hits him through that trap.
Well, fun start to this one as period number one comes to an end. We've still got lots more still in store. Kids are coming out on the ice here to play the little mini prospects game. And we'll be back in the morning.
Dude, we played a game and it was Soupy and Net, an RP game, and we got all the way to 2.8 seconds, and then the other team scored.
Looking to break out of their own end.
Oh, yeah, right.
Now. Stays with it. And now it's over to B-Bunny. Puts it on net. Stopped by the goaltender. Turns another aside. Really sharp. Never loses sight of the puck to make the second save. An all-out sprint and icing is waved off.
Yeah, the officials looking at both players to see who can get to the top of the circle first with a...
He's scoring! I believe Colin Barnes likes to call those back-to-back.
Yeah, the coaches want you to stay aggressive after you score. They do that, and they're able to...
Crown prospects are back to center ice, and they have narrowed that gap.
Cut the lead in half. The comeback's on. Now they must push forward, see if they can get the equalizer.
Chase right in front. Oh, and he just got enough of that one to keep it out. Here's a chance in front.
It is.
The building explodes. She's got her turn, and everybody's tossing hats onto the ice. She does great work in this close quarters here, James. The puck's on her stick, it's off the stick, and the goalie can't react.
Toronto's got a hold of the puck off the draw. And he lowers the boom there. There's a solid collision. Toronto's gained possession along the boards. And now they look to make something happen from the neutral zone. Fires it on net. Comes up with a monster save in front.
Yeah, he makes a nice save here with the glove, as you mentioned, but he's able to hang on to it. That's a tough save from this position on the ice.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. The Wolves have recently taken a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. Along the wing up the neutral zone. And that's broken up. Takes the shot. And he had an answer with that save.
We got a whistle as the puck goes in.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's not. Shit.
Puck possession so critical in today's game, and the official ready to drop the puck right here. Toronto's won the draw. And here's the pass. He's got a breakaway.
Oh, my God.
Same place for 100 years.
Oh, it's
just
I can't believe that. It's okay, I don't choke in league games.
And now it is just a deficit of one.
What a difference just the one goal makes in the way that
I don't miss
the
open
game.
Mess in
what
league games.
What makes you think is possible? They only need one more to even this up.
Toronto's ready to go on the attack. Centering pass.
Yes.
Okay, Toronto's got an insurance marker here. They now lead by two in the second.
Don't back off, though. Keep pushing ahead. Play the game in the offensive half of the ice.
New York's grabbed a hold of the puck. Toronto's got it now. Denies him!
He just doesn't want me to score.
And now he passes up to King. New York's got possession of the puck.
Oh, don't ignore that, James. I don't know if it sounded big where you were. It is now, I'm telling you.
Here's a chance to make something.
Oh, Dave,
who
are you, Dave?
The seventh round prospects gain possession along the wall.
How is that not open again?
Control for a second there, but regains possession. Feeds the puck up to Fisher.
Good play.
Here's a scoring chance. 2-on-1. B-Bunny's got the puck in his own zone. Here's a shot. What a stop as he puts out the fire. That's moved up ahead. Still to come. Third period action right after we get a clean sheet of ice.
I still don't have that helmet somewhere.
with both.
Just moments away from the start of the third period. It's been a throwback to 80s hockey here, and we are underway here in the third. With play underway here in this third period, we take it down to ice level and our own Ray Ferraro with his thoughts.
Toronto's offense has been awesome. Their play without the puck, and not so good. So you better find a way to score a couple more if you want to win tonight.
Forgot something here.
Playing from the corner. Comes up with a big pad save to deny. They are really dialed in here tonight.
Oh, come on.
Takes position. Takes the feed in the middle of the ice. Oh, look at this chance. He kicks it. Great save by the goaltender on that one. From the right side, takes the pass. Across the line and on the attack. It's a two-way. He scores!
Great patience with the puck. He didn't have much room, but she throws the goaltender. And like the Hall of Famer, Tammy Granato makes no mistake. She's just so good when she has time to shoot the puck. Now you're on a breakaway. You got enough moments to pick your spot, find out how you're going to shoot it, and she does not miss.
And he slides it quickly to Fisher. Takes the saucer pass. And that carries off a body in traffic. She takes the feed. Looks to get the puck over to King.
Yeah!
Here comes a penalty shot.
Morgan Rielly, fucking superstar there. Oh, good boy.
You go in on the penalty shot, you've got to be decisive. You're looking at the goalie trying to read him, but you have to have a really good idea what you want to accomplish. There's not much room once you get that close to the goaltender. She's so accurate. She puts it in the perfect spot that's in the net.
The officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another face-off here. Takes it into the slot, and that's clutch in traffic. Plays the puck up ahead.
King's contributed to the goal with one goal already.
And now he tries to get it across to B. Bunny.
I hope people at home aren't going away to grab a sandwich or something. By the time they come back, there's two more goals. It's like the goal of one here.
Centering to the middle. And another pass. What a great read breaking up the pass. And now he moves it to Fisher. She's got a step on the breakaway.
A little indecisive. She's in the clear, and she looks like she wants to deke, but maybe she's going to shoot. And pretty soon there's no room. And it's not even a scoring chance.
Rocks him. Just gets a piece of it to keep it out. Wow. Toronto's got possession here in their own end. Trying to gain a step.
Oh, I suck. Just don't let me play anymore. Whatever. He is fucking done.
He's got a little jump.
Oh, my God.
Save on the play. New York's got it along the wall. And that's off target as it hits a
it is.
Oh, what a chance here!
Thank you, you dink. Look. Trying to waste time.
Toronto's got the puck in the defensive end. Behind the net, looking for the transition game.
Breakaway. Oh.
Gives it right back.
I had a breakaway to nothing.
Well, they get the win and really control many of the small areas of the game. They were good in the faceoff. The center ice position is such a strength for them.
And we're home fatty there, we're home. Or poopy or whatever they call you. I don't know. Cool. double dose. Double dose is going to change to a big player, so just be weary. He's good at that. He likes to change it, see? Oh, he went small. He went small. Alright. I got too close. No, Mike, it's not Mike.
Here in the back half of this period, we've still got zeros on the board. Off the draw, he ties up his opponent. Looking to set up offensively. Slides it across. Denies him in close. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Montreal's got the puck. And he regains control of the puck.
That was great.
God's got to be frustrating for the goaltender. You make that much of a save, like you've almost completely shut it down, but it still squeaks by you into the net.
Montreal's moving it into the offensive end. Toronto's got a hold of it along the wall. King's got the puck. Settles things down and gets control of it once again.
What?
Three on one. Here they come on the attack. He scores!
In close, one of the game's better shooters. You cannot leave him alone. He does not miss there.
Getting into the later stages of this period, the next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Grabs the puck in the defensive zone. Grabs the puck. Toronto's got control of it now from their own end. All alone!
Goaltender comes up big in good position to make the
well,
save.
I passed down, not up. What the fuck? It's not okay, man. This is bullshit.
We got a face-off coming up.
Like, all of a sudden, my on-ice trainers come on. Like, it's something is fucked up, man.
And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Oh, at the buzzer, a big save!
I'm sorry,
and with that, the first period comes to an end. Both teams will have a chance to get a breather, and they'll be back on the ice with period number two in not too long.
I all of a sudden have these fucking arrows shooting down the ice in red and...
because almost every fan is in their seats here. Scores! And look who it is! His first goal with his new EASHL team!
The excitement that he displays when that puck goes into the net, you know how much this means. You will never forget your first goal.
Guys, this is actually his first goal with this club, and you know his teammates are going to be just as stoked as he is on this one. Lots more to see from this player right here.
That pass doesn't go. And that was stopped. Kiprusoff's going to cover it up for a faceoff.
While his team's ahead, he wants to make sure the pace of the game stays at the level they like.
Lots of time left in this period. Montreal's got a one-goal lead. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Great save by the goaltender who was in the right place at the right time.
You all right, bud?
What a hit!
Man, James, we're feeling that up here. What a solid body check delivered there. He's... Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
Here we go. One man.
That's sliding, not skating, bud.
She's serving up some attitude. There's the whistle. Look at this penalty shot.
You have to be able to shoot the puck on the breakaway. Getting hooked will result in a penalty shot.
One-on-one with the goalie.
They say,
makes the save.
Oh, that's a tough one, but a good stop. What a shot this is. The goalie thinks he's got the entire net covered. I guess not. This is just inside the post.
Play set to resume with the face-off ready to go. Montreal's won the draw. We got a whistle offside to call. More than half the period left to play. The Rockets now lead by two. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Jordan's got it into offensive territory. And a great save!
Quick pass over to King. Gaining steam here on the attack.
All right, Buds.
Oh, a good textbook hit there. And that somehow stayed out of the net. Passes it in front. Oh, what a chance. And he fanned on the puck. And we've got a two-on-one. Toronto's got the puck in their own end. He scores! That's three on the road. I can't imagine too many hats being tossed, though, here.
No, there's not going
to
be.
Dude, in their zone, I passed that twice to you, and it went, right, it didn't go.
Nobody's throwing their bucket.
I'm frustrated right now.
Well, that's one way to win the draw, as he skates away with the puck after the two centers were tied up. Look at that hit. Maybe try to wear down the opponents here. Trying to shake loose.
All right, Buzz.
Oh, she's not going to be very happy with herself there. Tries a little bit too fine to make the perfect shot. Doesn't force the goalie even to make a save. King's plate is getting a little fuller by the moment here. As the captain of this team, he's got to be the one to rally them. He's got to be the one to show them a way out of this mess they're in.
And the puck leaves the zone, going back to center ice. Quick pass to King.
Much.
Oh, he had the right idea, but couldn't make that play with the pass. Glove save! Quick reflexes!
He makes the glove stop right from the slot. That's a dangerous chance.
Past the midway mark in this period, Montreal's been showing relentless pressure lately, now up by three. And there's a little help from your friends.
All right,
there from off the wing, coming up with the puck. Back to the point it goes. And he gets in front of that.
Kiprusoff's goaltending at one end and the offensive output at the other has made for a good night.
He might have a step here.
Scores!
Clinical! Toronto's given themselves something that everybody in sports longs for. Hope here, Ray.
Hope? A chance? Hey, it's here.
Something!
Time isn't the enemy yet.
Dumps the puck in. The Wolves have it now. And a good solid hit on that play. Montreal's got possession here.
Scores!
Had about as much room as a Wolves. I don't even know if they make those anymore, but what a goal!
I don't think they do, James, but he's in close quarters. He has no room really to maneuver, but he does not miss very often from there. That's a great shot. We look at his goal again, James, and you notice how close he can get to the net, but how accurately he delivers the puck. That's a tough one for the goalie to handle.
Kane's taking it from his own end. It's a two-on-one. The Wolves get a hold of the puck in their own end. Nearing the 40-minute mark of the game. The Rockets scoop it up along the boards. Lead pass ahead. Intercepted the pass. Great read with the stick. And there's the horn, bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. Alongside Ray Ferraro between the benches, I'm James Cebulski, ready to bring you period number three. It's been a total mismatch here as we get underway for the third. Let's see if anything changes. Once again, I'll send it back down to my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, who is at ringside. Ray, we've got two periods played. Trying to gain a step. All alone! Broken up! Moves it to the middle! Takes a blast! Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that? Moves it to the middle! Great defensive play to pick off the pass!
Just having an amazing night. Every time he touches the puck, a couple of things happen. It ends up in the back of the net, and the home crowd boos him every time he gets with near it.
Cutting to the front of the net. Big save by the goaltender washing that one. Heads to the back of the net. Wow. He scores!
That's how you do it.
Leadership to a T. The captain capitalizes. The Wolves for a huge counterpunch. Now they need more of these here, Ray.
They've played really well. They've had the puck a lot. They've had lots of chances. They can't finish.
2-on-1. The Wolves look to start the transition game. Moves it in front. He scores!
Another great pass, dude. Thank you.
Woo!
She's really good at finding the open player, but she takes no mercy. Man, that puck is zipped. Crisp and flat on the tape.
Toronto's third period deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
Steps inside. Here's the pass. And turns aside the slaughter with ease. Montreal's got the puck against the board. Ahead from the left wing. Moves it to the middle. Oh, and they can't connect on the pass because it was broken up in front. Kane stick handling in his own zone. Moves the puck behind the net. Maintains possession. And makes the routine save. Kiprusoff's going to hang on for a whistle here in the third.
Well, there's not much time left here as you get into the final 20 minutes. The game's close. A mistake now would be critical.
Past the midway mark of the frame, Toronto's trailing by one. While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. And that's knocked away in the defensive end by Kane. Kiprusoff's gonna slow things down and opts for the whistle.
He's had a really good night. He's been on top of his game, and there's not been much that's given him trouble.
Kane's been rewarded for his efforts so far in this one, guys. He's even used his zone ability to generate some offense.
Toronto's got it, and they're on the attack. Kane's got it along the wing. He got rocked again.
He's
got
to get his head up here. They're going to be carting him off the ice.
Kiprusoff's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
A fake face-off here inside the offensive end. Jordan's won the draw in his own end. Now let's see if they can clear it. Here we go. 2-on-1. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Montreal's got a hold of it along the wall. Here's a shot. Stopped by the goaltender. Here's a shot. Oh, another big stop.
Bang, bang. Two unbelievable stops. One right after the other. He's got no help from anyone in front of him. He's got to do it all himself.
Late goings of this period. The Rockets are in an offensive battle tonight. They lead it 5-4. Jordan's gained possession and his great work inside the faceoff circle pays off again. Gets it over to King. And now it's to Jordan. And sends it just out of reach. At center ice now. He grabs the puck. Breakaway. there with that collision. Slides the puck across to King. Good stand-up hit on the play. Now, trying to shake the defender. Great back check on the play. And he has the answer on that one. Ref blows the whistle.
Oh, good, because I'm part of the Red Cross program right now.
As the puck's covered up. A big draw looming here in the offensive zone. And sneaks in there on the tie-up and comes up with the puck. Montreal's got the puck. Trying to get 2Q with it and loses possession. Toronto's looking to break out. A centering feed! Can't connect the play. And we got a delayed penalty coming up here. Look at this. It's a penalty shot.
She made a desperation stab on the breakaway, but that's going to cost the penalty shot.
And here we go. Comes up big with a save. A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff.
Good games, guys. Sorry.
We won one, right?
Yeah. Reschedule.
So, his first win.